First, he wowed us with his silky smooth renditions of the big band era's greatest hits. Then he scared us to death as a diabolical serial killer.
What do you say, man? You have a little fun.
Now Harry Connick Jr. is the leading man opposite one of Hollywood's best-known ladies.
Well, I was over the moon for you back then, Birdie.
At age 30, Harry Connick Jr. seems to have it all, including a marriage to a former Victoria's Secret model.
You feel so secure in yourself and your relationship, you don't mind other men saying, I saw your wife in her underwear.
Harry Connick Jr. is a multi-talented performer who continues to make his mark, both as a musician and on the silver screen. To some, he is the second coming of Frank Sinatra. Good evening, I'm Monica Kaufman, and welcome to my latest edition of Close Up. And welcome to downtown Atlanta and Centennial Olympic Park. Tonight we'll meet Harry Connick Jr. and we'll get an inside look at urban radio's hottest morning man. He's Tom Joyner, known as the Fly Jock. Joyner is without a doubt the hardest working man in radio.
We're in Atlanta!
And we'll check in with former guests Tom Hanks, Jodie Foster, and Reba McEntire. But first, Harry Connick Jr. Harry Connick Jr. burst onto the international music scene in 1989 when he recorded several big band classics for the soundtrack to the film When Harry Met Sally. The soundtrack went double platinum. While it was Harry's first big break, his musical career started nearly 20 years earlier. Born and raised in New Orleans, Harry started playing piano when he was 3. He performed publicly for the first time at 6, and at age 10 recorded with a local jazz band. Before long, he was studying under some of New Orleans' most prominent jazz masters.
The music that you play, Ellis Marsalis, mm-hmm. was one of your teachers.
That's right.
You used to hang out with James
Booker. Yeah.
You were just a baby.
Yeah, I was pretty young. But in New Orleans, it's a common sight to see, you know, the young kids. You know, they have a little trombone player. They call him Trombone Shorty. He's about 10 years old. It's just part of the way things are done down there. The young musicians come up and the older guys really welcome them in.
Harry's mother, who died when he was 13, was a judge. His father, Harry Sr., has been the district attorney in New Orleans since 1973. In addition to their legal careers, the couple owned a record store.
Did you grow up, your daddy singing and your mom singing, I'm Just Wild About Harry?
You know, I played that with UB Blake because he wrote it, and he was 96 years old and I was 9, and we played that song together. That was amazing. The coolest thing about my parents is they let us do exactly what we want. My sister wanted to learn languages. We had some woman living with us from Saudi Arabia teaching her Arabic when she was like 12 years old. I wanted to go and play on Bourbon Street, you know, so I had my friends over banging on drums and stuff.
Harry Sr. shares his son's love of music.
He always wanted to be an entertainer. And I guess about 5, 6, 7 years ago, I invited him up on stage to sing with me because he has a really nice voice. And he came up there and he loved it. He started, you know, kind of doing it around town on the weekends and on, you know, after work, he would go down there, sing for a couple hours.
Harry Jr. recorded his first album in 1987 at the ripe old age of 19. The self-titled debut was a critical success. His second album, entitled 20, was released the following year and introduced audiences to Harry's silky, smooth singing voice. Since then, Harry has recorded 10 more albums, the most recent of which, entitled To See You, was released in the fall of 1997.
Let me love tonight.
Over the years, Harry has been recognized as a serious jazz, swing, and big band artist who's not afraid to delve into the funkier side of things. He's also learned that songwriting is more hard work than inspiration.
Somebody was spreading rumors about better days are coming.
Like if I had to wait for an eagle to fly across a beautiful dust sky or something. I never get to write anything. You know, I go lock myself in a room and make up stories, you know, about two people who never found love because or whatever. I just make up stories, and they're not autobiographical. They're just stories that I think are interesting, and that's kind of how I write.
I have been told you are a stern taskmaster when it comes to your bands and it comes to your trios.
Well,
is that true?
I'm a workaholic, and I really work hard to give the people a good show. And if I see guys on my bandstand talking, or if I see them showing up later, I just can't tolerate that. There's too many other people in line that want that job.
Connick made his on-screen debut in the 1990 feature Memphis Belle. Though he played a tail gunner in the film, he did have a chance to showcase his musical talent.
Oh, Danny boy, I love your soul.
Harry went on to play opposite Jodie Foster in Little Man Tate.
You want to try to hit the ball nice and low. That way you get a lot of backspin on it.
And terrified audiences as a perverse and strangely beguiling serial killer in Copycat.
What do you say, man? You have a little fun.
Then in 1996, he appeared with Will Smith in the smash hit Independence Day.
Hold me.
Harry currently is appearing in his first lead male role opposite Sandra Bullock in director Forrest Whitaker's romantic drama Hope Floats.
I don't know, you and Bill were up here. I was somewhere else. I mean, what would you have said if I had asked you out?
You're doing almost a movie a year, and it's kind of scaring your music fans. No, you did a new album, but
right. Is
one winning over the other, or is it important to have both?
Oh, I think I can do both. You know, I mean, I don't think I'm going to be doing 4, 5, 6 movies back to back, and I don't tour 12 months out of the year. So I think there's time to do both. It's just a question of prioritizing and, you know, making everything fit in the schedule, really.
Harry's dual career has drawn comparisons to Frank Sinatra.
I can see why people do it, you know. I mean, the real musicians a lot of times compare me to Nat King Cole because we're both piano players and we have more of a sound quality in our voice than, say, me and Sinatra do, more of a similarity. But, you know, people are going to do that for 30 more years, you know. But that's cool. That's not what I thrive on, you know.
What do you thrive on?
I thrive on the music and I thrive on the acting and I thrive on my family. That's what I thrive. I don't thrive on what people are saying. I never have.
4 years ago, Harry married former Victoria's Secret model Jill Goodacre. The couple has 2 daughters, 10-month-old Kate and 2-year-old Georgia.
Did you sing to get your wife's attention when you were
Man, I would have lit myself on fire to get her attention. Shoot, sing. That was the least of my attention-getting devices.
How did you woo her?
Man, I count my blessings every day. I got her conned. It's been 8 years, and she still ain't figured it out. That's the heist of the century, man. She just could tell how much I was into her, you know. And, you know, when you love somebody like that, they can tell.
You feel so secure in yourself and your relationship, you don't mind other men saying, I saw your wife in her underwear.
Oh, man, I never did mind that. I don't know why. People would ask me, do you get jealous? I said, well, I don't understand what I have to be jealous of. You know, they've been modeling lingerie for 100 years, you know. Fortunately, the women themselves haven't been modeling for 100 years. That'd be gross like a mother, you know what I mean? Imagine that.
Just like virtually every New Orleans native, the Big Easy runs through Harry's veins. But for now, Harry is content to live in suburban New York with his wife and daughters. He doesn't plan on moving back home anytime soon.
The drug scene is so bad down there, and the crime scene is so bad. I mean, it's too dangerous to live there. I just don't want to raise my kids around that.
Harry Connick Jr. is just 30 years old. He's already enjoyed what most people would call a full career as an actor and Grammy-winning musician. For Harry, the best is apparently yet to come. But despite all of his success, Harry has not lost his connection with his roots. He knows that his music is still what makes him tick.
You still get excited about your music.
Oh, it's all I know how to do. If I can't get excited about that, I'm in trouble. Because, you know, I don't think I'd be good at anything else. You know, I got to get excited about something.
Harry told me he enjoys acting, but he says music will always be his first love. Something tells me we'll be hearing a lot more from Harry Connick Jr.